has come to our family. You remember our venerable house? Opulent and imperial, gazing proudly from its stoic perch above the moor. I lived all my years in that ancient, rumor-shadowed manor, fattened by decadence and luxury. And yet I began to tire of conventional extravagance. Singular, unsettling tales suggested the mansion itself was a gateway to some fabulous and unnameable power. With relic and ritual, I bent every effort towards the excavation and recovery of those long-buried secrets, exhausting what remained of our family fortune on swarthy workmen and sturdy shovels. At last, in the salt-soaked crags beneath the lowest foundations, we unearthed that damnable portal of antediluvian evil. Our every step unsettled the ancient earth, but we were in a realm of death and madness. In the end, I alone fled laughing and wailing through those blackened arcades of antiquity, until consciousness failed me. You remember our venerable house, opulent and imperial. It is a festering abomination. I beg you, return home, claim your birthright, and deliver our family from the ravenous, clutching shadows of the darkest dungeon.
Bom, bom, bom. Darkest Dungeon is about making the most of a bad situation. Quest will fail or must be abandoned. Heroes will die, and when they die, they stay dead. Progress autosaves constantly, so actions are permanent. The game expects a lot of you. How far will you push your adventurers? How much are you willing to risk in your quest to restore the hamlet? What will you sacrifice to save the life of one of your favourite heroes? Thankfully, there are always fresh souls arriving on the stagecoach, yada yada, that are willing to look for fame and fortune in the darkest dungeon. Bum-bum-bum. Welcome everybody to the first episode of Darkest Dungeon. It has been released finally. It's a game that I've had on my wish list for almost a year, basically. When I first heard about it and I seen somebody streaming it, I know very little about the game other than what I've played. And I've played about an hour of it, which I recorded for you. And then I realized my recording software was kind of screwing up the game. And this is all you've seen for like an hour of gameplay. But I was going through it and I was learning, but that's a good thing because I've made the mistakes and now we can get on with a nice smooth episode of The Darkest Dungeon. We could continue off where I left off, but I don't want to do that. I want to give you the full flavor flav. So I got to week 3 in the hamlet and this is the letter. He addressed it to the Darkest McReeps, but we're going to change that. We're going to delete this game. Thank you very much. And then this way we can go through all the menus and everything a little bit quicker. So it works out. It works out. And I am streaming over on Twitch, so if I seem distracted, it's because I am. I was just looking at chat for a second there. It works out in the favor of you guys over on YouTube because you don't need to deal with that headache of me reading the menus and saying, what's that for? How do we do this? So let's click the letter. And we're going to call it, it's going to be something hamlet, so we'll just call it the McReeps hamlet, right? McReeps. And enter, thank you very much. So as it says, when somebody dies, they're gone for good. Oh, another little cutscene for me to shut my mouth, you watch. I love the art style.
Drive along the old road. It winds with a troubling serpent-like suggestion through the corrupted countryside, leading only, I fear, to ever more tenebrous places. There is a sickness in the ancient pitted cobbles of the old road, And on its writhing path, you will face viciousness, violence, and perhaps other damnably transcendent terrors. So steel yourself, and remember, there can be no bravery without madness. The old road will take you to hell, but in that gaping abyss, we will find our redemption.
Well, this is what happens when you give the reins to a mad old homeless guy by the looks of it, just jumped on. He was running them horses way too hard on that little road. Upon returning to the hamlet, be sure to check the activity log to see what has transpired in your absence. I never realised things did transpire in your absence. So we're still learning. Okay, map navigation. I'll show you. I don't need to read that. I'll show you guys. So basically, these are the rooms in this dungeon, or on our road to the hamlet. As you can see, our little chariot is a smashed, because that driver was awful. We have this guy, Reynold, he's a bit of a knight type character, as you can see. This is his gear down here, his skills that we have. We can move him backwards and forth, so we can switch position with this guy. And I think we can do this as many times as we want when we're not in combat and we're transitioning between rooms or rooms that we've already completed. Up here is our light source. The more light there is, the more confident your guys feel, and you have all of these things. So we're able to see further ahead. We're able to surprise the monsters. When it gets a little bit darker, it flips around, but with increased difficulty, it comes increased reward. So you can kind of snub out the light if you want a more challenging run, but more reward. And we'll get into that in maybe other episodes. Maybe this episode, we'll see. So we have two characters here. We have this little guy, who's Dismas, and Reynold. Now, neither of these are actually us. They're just protecting us. They're escorting us to the hamlet, is what I've found out. So we use A and D to move forwards and backwards across the little screen that we have here. But we have to tell it we want to move to this room.
Brigands have run up these lanes. Keep to the side path. The hamlet is just ahead.
Ooh, okay, so you got the hallway movement, which I was just telling you about. We're going to go ahead. I don't know what this is. I still have no idea. Like, I'm an hour and a bit into the plane of the game, and I've got no idea what that is. It looks like this symbol, so I'm wondering if it's just losing light and then he's noticing it and he's getting scared. I'm not entirely sure.
Dispatch this thug in brutal fashion, that all may hear of your arrival.
Just a regular brigand popped up out of nowhere. The art style is amazing. The music is amazing. The RNGness is awful, but great and glorious all at the same time. So we're like halfway across from our starting room to the room that we want to go to, which is our hamlet. And this guy's popped up. So we can't pick who attacks. At least I don't think we can. And I don't know what these... Oh, that's stress. That is stress. These white dots on the bottom is his stress level, apparently. Actions remain in one. And we're going to take a thing here. So we can attack this guy using our skills. And down here, the skills that aren't lit are skills that we can't use because he's in the wrong position. So as you can see on the yellow, like just at the top of the skill panel above where it says pistol shot, you have four dots on the left and four dots on the right. The yellow dots is the position that the character's in. So currently he's in the first position, he's in the second, there could be the third and fourth position. This skill can only be used from the third to the first position, and it can only attack something in the first or second position, whereas this one can only attack from the second to the fourth position of the enemies over here. So you kind of got to move them around or force them around. It's a nice little interesting mechanic to the game that I'm still very much getting used to. We can pass a turn, but you will suffer stress for passing a turn. I don't know why you'd want to just yet, but I'm sure there's reason for it. So we're going to go ahead and just slap this guy in the face. I'm not sure how you know how much damage it's going to do. Oh, it's based on... Okay. I've just figured that out now. So it's based on 85 accuracy damage. And we're going to have a damage mod of minus 15%. It's definitely going to bleed for 2 points. 2 points per round for 3 rounds. Okay. So that's kind of interesting. 85 minus 15%. Get slashed. He resisted the bleed element, but he did take a good old hit. He's debuffed us and everything. You know what? We're just going to smite you down, boy.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
It's just so good. The narrator's fantastic. The music's good. The visual aesthetic, I just adore. I think it's great. Rifling through the corpse reveals 1,000 gold. He was a thirsty old bandit. You'd think he'd leave it at home, surely. So he's still debuffed. He's got bleed resist for 3 rounds. Minus 15% bleed resist for 3 rounds. We can come up to things in the background here. We can search. You search with the person that you've currently got selected. And that's important later on, I think, for when things are booby-trapped or certain things somebody doesn't like. You don't want to stress them out by saying, okay, go search that body, if they have a fear of rifling through dead bodies. And fears are a very real thing. Fears, addictions, and just, you'll see, let's just get on with it. March, friends. No, we're not going to march. We're checking out a brigand's tent, clearly where the ambushes camp. So they left a bunch of sapphires and some gold.
There's much to be found in forgotten places.
So the loot's randomized, which is kind of nice. I got rubies the first time and a bunch more gold, sorry. Once you get here, you can move into the next thing. The light is being reduced the further we go. So now we're getting more stress, we're receiving less scouting, and the monsters aren't going to be quite as surprised because we can't see them as far, right? So let's just pop into the room.
An ambush. Send these vermin a message. The rightful owner has returned, and their kind is no longer welcome.
He is a big boy. He's definitely a big boy. So what we're going to do is, this is going to buff out itself. It'll give us plus 6 accuracy, plus 5 crit. It's going to do damage of 95 based on a minus 80% damage mod. So we're going to do a lot less damage. However, we are going to buff ourselves. And we're going to do it. We can only do it to, in fact, we can do it to them both. We're going to take out this guy, I think. Or yeah, do this. Get them both. Oh, he's going to hit us, but we dodged. These guys almost killed me my first time through. So add 6 to a torch, which would reduce our stress. It would give us 25% more protection, but it would mark his. Stunning blow would guarantee to stun someone. I would like to stun, I guess, this big fella, because he's not gone yet. He didn't resist the stun. We'll just keep chipping away at this guy. Wow.
To a killing blow.
He seriously just crit. Please don't kill me. Well, you get hit. And then we'll do the same. Please die. He is bleeding, so he's on his way out. He's bleeding, I'm bleeding. We are going to, we're going to try stun him, I think. Just so he doesn't get another attack.
A victory. Perhaps the turning point.
So when the corpses drop to the floor, they do still take that floor space. So people aren't going to move up the ranks from the right most place upwards. So this guy's still in the third location, because his first location is taken by the chest, second location is taken by the big corpse, and then the third location is this guy. We might die here. I don't know how strong that bleed is. This looks like our stress level for sure. 21 of 200. 10 of 200. It makes sense. We can't do anything there, but we can shoot him in the face. Oh, you're going to do the dodge? Okay. And he's going to just keep chipping at the pair of his. The battles are amazing. They're really good. There will be no blood left. I would love to. Can't do anything there. We literally can't hit that guy. But we can buff ourselves up. Although we have marked ourselves, which will probably allow him to hit us harder. Can you get a good shot on him? Yes, you can. Give them no quarter. Good job, Dismas. Rifling through their corpses revealed a nice bunch of stuff. We got a couple of deeds, crests, gold. These are the crests, gold, and deeds. Or sorry, the deeds and crests are used to upgrade our buildings when we get back to the hamlet. So we're going to go ahead and take all of these. And I made a mistake last time, so I'm glad I kind of have to redo it. So after you complete a quest, the requirements of a quest, you have the option to return to town at any time. Just click on the crest icon. You don't need to return to the starting room of the dungeon to exit. So I just returned to the hamlet last time. I was like, yeah, of course, let's go to the hamlet. That's our mission, right? No. Continue adventuring, and then we can just click it up here whenever we want to escape. But there's a nice wee chest here, so let's look at it. And I'm not going to open it with this guy, just in case it's booby-trapped, so we'll open it with him. He's got more health. 13. You know what? You're probably more resistant. A bandit's trap chest. Something doesn't look quite right about this one. Okay, you ignore it. You go for it. It's trapped. Blast it. Did you not? Okay. So that was just to show us that things can be booby-trapped. Have you got any bad effects? I thought you had disease. So he's a known cheat. And these are negative traits. He's God-fearing, but he's prone to steal stuff. So we shouldn't really let him pick anything up from chests, because he might not give us it all. At least that's what I'm thinking. But there we go. The prelude is a complete victory. 5,000 bonus gold we got. Collected the treasures, everything there, and all of our rewards that we actually collected down the bottom. But we'll get random traits. These are either good or bad traits that can be given to us. Last time, neither of my guys got anything good or bad. So this is going to be interesting. Oh my god. He's obsessed with self-worship. Is that masturbation? It could very well be. Hey, we got a good one. 20% less stress damage when in the warrens. Okay, very nice. And that's the great thing about this game, it's different all of the
time.
Welcome
home, such as it is. This squalid hamlet, these corrupted lands, they are yours now, and you are bound to them.
Thank you very much, caretaker. Thank you very much. He looks a little bit stressed. So he's basically opened up the gateway to hell and decided, you know what? I can't do anything with this. I'm going to re-elect all of my bloodline and get them to come and bail me out the shit. So that's what we are. We're basically the cleanup crew for his massive mistake. He's opened the gateways to hell. Week 1, Dismas is now an apprentice. Reynold is now an apprentice. And these guys successfully escorted us to the hamlet. That's all that's happened. There's a bunch of goals. Hey, if we can click on this maybe? There we go. Look at all of the different goals we have. And then we have roster goals, raise an abomination to resolve. Arbalest, Bounty Hunter, Crusader, Grave Robber, Hellion, Highwayman, Houndmaster, Jester, Leper, Man-at-Arms, Occultist, Plague Doctor, and Vestal. So level 6 must be the highest level, and these are all the different classes, which is pretty cool. This is our roster on this side over here. Get help where you may. It's just basically saying push H and we'll get some help. It's very nice. So all of these different buildings come into play eventually. We've not unlocked them yet. So we need to do more quests to unlock the tavern, the survivalist, sanitarium, where we remove people's ailments and problems that they're having, addictions and all that sort of stuff. The abbey, where we relieve the stress if they're that way inclined. If they want to pray to the god or meditate, or they're a religious sort, they'll go in there. You get the tavern, where eventually we'll unlock it, but you can send them to the brothel if they just want a good old release, a literal stress release, or you can send them in to gamble. The thing is, if you keep them in these places for too long, they might actually develop an addiction where we have to send them to the sanitarium again, and it costs money to keep them in there to remove these negative traits of theirs. I've just noticed there's a day-night cycle in town. That's pretty amazing. The guild, I think we send them there to upgrade their skills. The blacksmith, I'm pretty sure you send them there just to upgrade the weapons. We have the nomad wagon, which I have got no idea what that's for. We've got the memoirs and the graveyard. Oh yeah, and also the stagecoach. The stagecoach is where it brings in new heroes each week. So every time we do an embark, we come back to town, there'll be more heroes just chilling out in the tavern, in the stagecoach. And we can decide whether to then bring them onto our roster or tell them to get out of here. But I'm really enjoying this game so far. We're going to do one really quick embark. We'll have a look at here, let it explain things to us. So in the graveyard,
we'll end up here, covered in the poisoned earth, awaiting merciful oblivion.
Nice. So you may die, you probably will die, and when you do, at least you've got a nice warm welcome from the caretaker, who's giggling at your demise. Thanks, caretaker, you arsehole. And then we could always go down here to
in
check.
In time, you will know the tragic extent of my failings.
Good. So this story's going to unfold. So we've done the prologue. You've seen the both intros. But then the story continues, if we can grab this again. Whoop! Yeah, it looks like there's what, three sections. You got like a little intro area here, and then the main brunt of the story, and then a bit of an epilogue at the end. Looking forward to unraveling the story. I don't know if we'll be able to do it on our first playthrough. We'll see. I'm guessing you can run out of coin, you can run out of everything and not be able to hire anybody. I'm not sure, because I'm not 100% sure if it costs anything. So far, what I've played, it doesn't cost anything to bring them in. You just need to have empty seats for them. So at the minute, we've got 2 of 9 in our roster. Come over to the stagecoach, and it's just going to tell us
men, soldiers and outlaws, fools and corpses. All will find their way to us now that the road is clear.
Very good. It's just going to tell us now, basically drag these onto our roster like a saw.
What better laboratory than the blood-soaked battlefield?
Hey, you're not going to tell me about this one? Oh, I'm sorry. So these have got different names. We can rename these guys. We can upgrade our stagecoach. Which we're going to do, we're going to upgrade the network. So next week, there'll be 3 heroes to choose from in here.
Word is traveling. Ambition is stirring in distant cities. We can use this.
We can use this. So with every upgrade comes a little narration, basically saying how the family names getting a little bit more renown, and everybody's wanting to take part. Come and get the riches and things like that. But if we right click on these guys, we can change the name up here. So if you want to be part of this band of misfits, you can. If you want to be a certain class, let me know. When we employ the services of that class, we'll name you that person. We can change the colors if you want a specific color. I think there's only three colors there, isn't there? Five outfits. It looks like there's three colors and a couple of abbreviations of it. But if there's a certain color that you'd prefer, just let me know. We'll see what we can do. This little person's got a guilty conscience. This is all random as well. So, Falcon? Fawson? Falcon. I'm going to call you Falcon. And your name's never going to change. Combat skills. She prefers to be in the third position, which is pretty important because a lot of the skills, like third position, third position, third position, third position. She can use all of her skills in the third. Only one skill are these two skills attack, which is kind of cool. My little dude never had this last time, Dazzling Light. We had Illumination. She didn't have any bad quirks though, at all. So bears the crushing guilt of deeds, real and imagined. Wait. So if we don't do something, she's going to think that we've done it anyway. That's going to build up her stress. So we need to kind of unlock the sanitarium pretty quick and get rid of this one, because that could turn bad pretty quickly, I think. All of the stats, what she looks like, is kind of cool. But yeah, as I said, we can go up here, we can rename and dismiss. What about this guy? What did you get? Oh dear God. 20% stress damage versus humans. Great, why not? And it's also kind of got a lazy eye. -5 accuracy when using ranged skills, which are most of them, I think. A grenade seems like it's ranged. Oh no, melee, yeah. So the ranged skills are pretty bad. We need to kind of get rid of the lazy eye as fast as we can. Give him some spectacles. Spectacles for you. Known cheat. And God-fearing kleptomaniac, egotistical, self-worshipping clown features. If you'd like to be this knight in shining armor that obsesses about himself and has got sticky fingers, let me know. We can change a couple of things about him. Oh, I clicked. Didn't do anything. That's fine. So we're full on knight now. We're going to do a quick embark. What we got down here? The activity log. That's fine. Trinket inventory. I've never put anything in here. I don't know what goes in there. And then the glossary just to show us what's what. And the options menu. It's nice. The art style's really cool. We're going to go on another embark.
A mecca of madness and morbidity. Your work begins.
Thank you very much. So we've got the estate map. And this is just a scouting mission. Test yourself in the mad realm of your fallen ancestor. Take note of how creatures have taken over, but don't delve in too far. So we're just going to pop our head in. Just the tip. Oh, okay, these are the warrens. So our guy's good in the warrens. The ruins is where we're going to take a little peek. The darkest dungeon. We could go straight there. We are the flame. It's level 6. Medium length. And heroes will camp once during the quest. This all... We're obviously not going to do that. That's certain death. Now, we need to position our guys the way we want to. He can be one or two. Position one or two. And let's just see. He can only ever attack the first two people. But yeah, he can do this from either position. I'm going to pop him in here. Is there anything that you can do only from the first position? That one, but it's locked. I mean, you're pretty good. We'll go with the second position for you. Dismas. So Reynold and Dismas are the only two scripted people. Comrades, whatever you want to call them. For the first, or heroes, I guess they're called. The only two scripted heroes, because that's where the game starts. Everything else so far has been completely random. Even these guys, the negative traits have been random. which is really cool. Good replayability. So, second. Yeah. You can go there. Please tell me you're fourth for everything. Oh no, you need to be there. Like that. The usual suspects. Why did they get called something different? Red Hook? What have we went? I don't know what this is. It must be like the party set out in this way as a preset of Red Hook. No idea, we've not got that far into the game just yet.
The cost of preparedness.
So we've got to prepare for our journey. It tells you what you should go for, and I completely forgot to take a look. So I'm going to go with 10 food. Well, I want 11 food. I meant to go for 10 food, and we'll go for 8 torches. Because it's just a short embark. So let's go. We're not going to camp or anything during this one. We're just going to go ahead and give it a try. Oh, I didn't realise I had to click. Right. So now we've got a bit of a sprawling room layout rather. I would like to have a wee look, see how things are going. We only need to explore 90% of this, but we're going to go ahead and do all of it, I think. Take a wee walk. Go ahead. Take the torch. Take the unburnt torch. We get a bonus torch, not bad. Not all of the rooms that we go to are going to have enemies in. Some of them will, though. I guess this was the room that we was going to, so the rooms probably always have enemies in. But not all of the corridors, you're going to get ambushed in things. Food, torches we can use to increase the light level. We can't pick who we're going to play. Yeah, we definitely can't, it's just random I think. So, what do we want to do? Enemy parties clears all of the corpses over here. It shuffles a single. We can shuffle this guy if we want. I thought we could do these. Oh no, you're in the wrong place for it. Why can we not do this one? I guess this is all we can do. We can only do it to him. Which is good because he'll get shuffled. He's then stunned, so he can't do anything. We could probably... I can probably hit him because he's stunned, right? So he can't resist. He resisted the bleed, but he can't resist anything else. And this guy's only got 2 skills this team. We're going to stun this one. Now these guys are both going to miss the turn. Which is grand. We're going to just try keep them on lockdown, I think. He used his stun to buff himself up. Right, let's go for him. Take him out the equation.
A faint hope blossoms.
And now, because he's here, there's not much we can do. I guess we can clear the corpse. It's probably best just to... Whose go is it next, do we know? Let's buff up this guy. I'll maintain it, don't you worry. Good job, Troop. Good job. Rifling through the corpses reveals that they had a ton of money. And we don't know who's going to open it, so we'll go with you. The contents are yours. We got a shovel, a couple of crests, and more money. Some bonus money. Thank you very much. Oh, okay, so it's doing the scouting. We can move to the room. We know we're going to have a battle here. We know there's going to be an obstacle here. That's really cool. I never knew that that happened. So there's a chance of some scouting. Here's our obstacle.
Even the cold stone seems bent on preventing passage.
So we can either use the shovel, which will allow us to clear the obstacle, or we can clear the obstacle by hand, but it will take quite a bit of effort, which might result in more stress, it might result in monsters coming. We'll just use the shovel, it gave us it for that reason. And then we'll move on, and we know once we get up here, we're going to run into a battle. So then you can move you guys around accordingly. Once you're in, you're locked in combat, you can't move. Well, you can move where we want to here, but it will consume our turn. We can do this to buff ourselves up. We really want to be taking this one out. No dodge, no dodge. 13 dodge this scumbag's got. So I guess we just go hit all of them. You can use the plague grenade on this one. Okay. Oh yeah, of course. It can only be, yeah. I'll go with plague grenade. It might miss her though, but we'll give it a try. She's been blighted. Wow. That blight is seriously strong. You just got tickled by an octopus. Can't hold on to your balance. Hundred percent chance to stun if it lands. Oh yeah, the skills, all of the skills are different. We've never seen the Eldritch pull before.
Masterfully executed.
You're not going to be pulling anyone else, girly. Come on, Reynold, you can do it. Do the old stunning blow. It's almost going to be a guaranteed thing. 90 minus 75%. So what's the maximum that can be? 18 or something like that. I thought he was a guaranteed death. Wow, Blight destroyed you. Yep, go for it. Go nuts.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
Good job, Witch Doctor. And then the corpse is just moving around the ground, because why not?
Success.
Got some jade, gold, and crests.
Or is it merely a trick of the light?
I want to move this guy back to here now. And away we go! Rusty hauberk? Oh, that's just the gear he's wearing. Oh, we're doing a wee bit of scouting. We know we're going to have... Interactive objects here. Interactable objects. We have treasure here, and something here. Move to this room, battle with objects. Move to this room, battle with treasure. Let's battle with treasure. Oh, the torch. The light's fading. But it's going to increase our stress levels. Our guys are going to get stressed out a lot quicker. The monsters are going to have way more accuracy and damage. Heroes are going to get surprised, but we're going to get more crits and more loot out of it. It's not really worth it, I don't think. So I think what we'll do, we'll build our torches back up. Our scouting skills are way better. You have a look at stuff. Found a key and some gold, thank you. I keep forgetting this guy's a kleptomaniac, he's going to steal all of our stuff. Oh, they're surprised. So we get the jump on those guys. I mean he's got a good amount of hit points, no dodge. He's got protection, no dodge. There's a graveyard slash. He's resistant to bleed damage. Okay. Just go ahead and punch it all in the face. I would like to get you. If this lands, you're dead. And then we'll hit you right in the jaw. Give him a good old stun. We don't want the brawler going nuts on us for sure. Minus 20 dodge. Her dodge is 13. If we can do that, if we can get her to minus dodge. Oh yes. Okay, yeah, that guy was stunned. Oh, actions remaining. So this is their actions. That's cool. Alright. She can't dodge for shit, so we should be able to take her out of this. Hey! Just because she can't dodge doesn't mean that we can kill her, I guess. Let's stun that one.
Her death by inches.
Whose dodge should we go for? Neither of them have got dodge. Minus 50%. That's better damage as well, so we'll go with you. Wow. I'm taking him out because he's got graveyard slash and I don't know what it does. I don't really want to find out. Keep him stunned.
Confidence.
There we go.
The enemy crumbles.
What I'm talking about. You're about to get slashed, slash happy.
Press this advantage. Give them no quarter.
Good job. Right, do you want to open a chest? Go for it. It's got our family sigil, so it should be fine, right? 100 and a key. So now we got a couple more keys, or a couple of keys in total. Let us... we'll go back the way. I don't know if you can get attacked if you go back the way. I know it's going to take torch. Yeah, the light's dissipating, so. Go through to the room and then we'll go check this one out. We know for a fact we've got something here which you can open. Nice wee sack. Holy water, a bust, some gold. Thank you very much. And we know we're walking into a battle. So let's make sure our light's good. And we can surprise the monsters. Or there's more chance to surprise the monsters. Did you get surprised? Not in the slightest. I'm going to sneeze. Excuse me. Let's have a look. Hero to hit 85%, hero to crit. Oh, I didn't realize. I didn't realize that told you the chance, the percent chance. So 85% looks like we're going to do 1 damage. No damage there. Right, now I learned something. So I'm going to do 5 to 9 damage. 4 to 8 damage. Let's get an ace old crit. He's got protection though. What if we went like this? 4 to 8, 3 to 7. One to three. But it's also going to 100% stun. They've both got graveyard slash. Let's stun the guy at the front. Oh!
In radiance, may we find victory.
Good dodge. Good dodge, Desi. What's your name again? I forget your name. 2 to 3, 2 to 4. Or we can buff ourselves up. I think we'll buff ourselves. We have marked ourselves, so this guy will be able to take us out. Let's take this guy out if we can. He resisted the bleed? That sucks. Let's finish him off. And then let's spin him around. He can only go for him now, I think. Which is good. Now neither of them can attack us. Good job. Right where it hurts, right in the mummy daddy button. We can heal. Heal 1 to 1, cure blight, or we can cure blight bleed. We'll heal this one, I think. Why not? That's all we can do. That gives us +6 torch. How did you resist all of that? Debuff him. Give him a good old slap in the face. Good job, Dismas. Rifling through the corpses revealed gold. Oh, a blood charm. First charm I've ever found. +30% bleed resist. And an onyx. Black like endless night. We can sell them, I guess. You're not really the pious type. You go for it. The holy fountain. You're in your element there, girl. Aha! What did you find? Nothing, it just healed you a little bit. Let's go to the next room. I wonder if this will show us anything. I don't think so. Oh, it's a tarp. Okay, so some rooms have traps. Some corridors have traps. I guess if your scouting's good enough, There we go, we got a bit of scouting. There was a trap there as well. So we're not going to go back between those ones. And there's something curious over this way. Go for it, buddy. Uh-oh. Why did you whistle? No! His bad trait, he can't... I'll be keeping the reward for myself. Reward, hard earned. So that's what we would have taken. But he stole it all. Couldn't help it. That sucks. And it's just random. Like when you come up to stuff. Forward, we're going march. So hunger. The exertions of adventuring has produced a growing hunger amongst the party. So we can choose to feed them. We have enough food. We brought food with us. We got supplies. Or we could just not feed them, but they'll take damage plus a nice chunk of stress damage. He's pretty stressed over here. So we will feed them. They gain a little bit of health, and there's no negative side effects apart from the fact that you lose some food. So not only are you out here gathering all this stuff, you are doing resource management, you're stress managing these guys. Sometimes you'll just have to bugger off. You will just have to say, look, you know what, I'm done. But if you abandon it, you're classed as a failure when you get back to town. So that alone builds stress in your characters. It's a really cool little game mechanic. It's a massive juggling act. Quest complete. We're going to continue adventuring. We're very healthy. Before I wasn't doing so well, so I just went straight back to the hamlet. But we're going to continue. And is there anything that we can do here? Oh, what's this? So there's an obstacle in our way, and we can move to the room to... There's a battle room with treasure. The obstacle's probably a big pile of rocks again, right? We should keep moving. We don't have any shovel this time. So we'll have to do it by hand.
Without tools of iron, you must rely on flesh and indefatigable purpose.
Wow, we took damage. We took stress. And we basically screwed all of our late away because it took time. So time, stress, a little bit of health. Oh, this might be a bad idea. The tempting goblet. I don't want it. That doused his late a wee bit. Yeah, good dodge. They get to go first? I don't think that's fair. Right, so we're going to have to play this one smart. We can buff ourselves so we have more accuracy and more damage on the next one. Or, let's have a look. Tempting Goblet, we need to take him out. I don't like the sound of Tempting Goblet. Quarrel, he can make us argue. Graveyard Slash, he's the only one without anything, but he's probably going to beat the crap out of us because he's a big fella. Dodge. Okay. Let's just go hit these three if we can. Miss, and dodge, really? Okay, Plague Bomb. If it gets them both, we're laughing. He's got the blade. Why do you go? I don't understand how you know who's going to go next. I'm sure there'll be an indicator. 1-3, 2-3. Just because of his protection. Take the Graveyard Slash out of the equation. No. I'd like to stun this guy. My goodness. We might have to run away. You took a severe beating there. Okay, let's do it again. We can heal. We're gonna have to heal ourselves, I think. I really want to get this all over your face. Yes, you both took plate. Brilliant. And then we're going to buff ourselves up, give us some protection. It's going to mark us. He'll probably be able to hit us pretty hard when we're marked.
The light, the promise of safety.
He's going to attack us though. We've got our protection. That worked in our favour. He's taking a good bit of damage from the blade. Oh, that hurts. He's gone.
From becoming unwound.
He's gone. When a hero is just reduced to zero HP, they're at death's door. While in this state, they will suffer state penalties, plus any further damage has a chance to kill them. Heal them to get them off of death's door. I will heal you as soon as I can.
Gently. This is how a life is taken.
Please don't die. So we can heal him. Or we can damage that guy. I think we have to heal him, don't we? Get him off death's door. And then we have to do a big heal.
The slow death. Unforeseen. Unforgiving.
No! Oh, we're back down to one. So this here, is that death's door recovery? He's got minus 2, minus 5 damage, minus plus 10 stress damage. He's super stressed right now. His accuracy's all shot to shit. We can kinda buff ourselves up a wee bit. 47. Let's see if we can take him out. Yes, good job. He might be a little bit stressed, but Dismiss, you're coming back strong, buddy. We're gonna make it happen. Get him stunned. Just keep him. Oh, he's not stunned. We kinda need to keep him stunned. Anything going to stun him? He resisted the bleed. Resist the stun? No, we got him. Okay, that's good. That's good news. Now we could heal him up again. Or we can try and take this guy out. 1 or 2 damage. 1 to 4 damage. Heal him up again. And I'll let you finish him off. Go for it. Yes, death's door to becoming the hero.
Foolish horrors. Brought low and driven into the mud.
Okay, I've never done that before. We just ended the quest last time. And I've never seen anybody on death's door, so that was terrifying. So we got some food, citrine crest, and gold. I thought you were gone, Dismiss. I thought that was it, but the end was nigh. We're going to get the witch doctor guy to open this up because he's the most health. 20. With our family sigil, go for it. A portrait, an oil painting of some distant family relation, and a crest. And now we're done. We can go home. I'm ready. I feel Dismiss is going to have to go to the brothel. All of those things that we got. The busts. Oh, we got a portrait as well, is that? That shows up. Okay. I'm thinking this is a rare one because I've never seen it. Oh, Dismiss, please. Please don't get a negative effect. These two came away absolutely fine. Hey, very good. Scouting chance in the wield. Oh, nice. Brilliant stuff. And more. That's pretty good. If them two are both in the wield, we get a really good chance to scout both paths out, or multiple paths, before we take it. So we'll go back to town, and I think that's where we're going to end this episode. It should just tell us that the certain things are unlocked.
My obsession caused this great foulness, and it is shameful that I must rely upon you to set it right.
Yes, yes it is. So this is just showing us how to, like, cure obsessions, negative quirks. So when they become severe, over time, negative quirks will lock into place and become severe. Severe negative quirks cost much more to remove in the sanitarium. So the wee caretaker guy, I don't know if this is the guy that's been driven mad or if he's just the caretaker. But during week two, a tavern was open because there's heroes here and people of the village are like, let's make some coin. And the abbey was also open. So these are both places to relieve our stress. I'll just show you that very quickly.
The cobwebs have been dusted, the pews set straight. The abbey calls to the faithful.
Bum bum bum. So, our wee caretaker is enjoying the activities. He's in the penance hall. Take my blood as you have taken my mind. Woo! Ha ha ha. So you can pray to the higher power, meditate, or like go to the penance hall and just get flogged, basically. You can upgrade these so we can house more people, because at the minute we can only have one in each. We kind of need Dismas to do something, but we don't know what he likes and what he doesn't like just yet. And the tavern's the same, except it's for gambling, the brothels, and the bar.
And curtained rooms promise solace to the weary and broken alike.
The last time I done this, the caretaker wasn't like asking for penance or anything like that. He was in the brothel and he was having a barrel of laughs down here. We could throw Dismas down to the brothel, give him a little treat for being a hero, but it doesn't always work like that. So again, we have the upgrade. It's going to cost us a couple of portraits and crests to upgrade this guy. If I must return, I am ready. Dismas, you're not ready. This guy's super stressed. Let's have a little look at the stagecoach, actually. So we've got another crusader here. He's got a fear of beasts. And he's not very accurate when it comes to beasts. He's good at meditating, improves stress reduction while meditating. And he's got good melee skills. Apart from that, he's got this, oh no he's not, he's got different skills and different camping skills. We'll need to take a look, because Reynold, I don't like the fact that you're going to steal shit off me, dude. And then we've got Pascal, thin-blooded, not very good when it comes to the blight, but it's pretty good heal skills while camping. So that's a bonus, 50% chance to heal for more when camping. We've never seen this one before, a little arbalist, looks like it's a lot of range stuff, which makes sense for an arbalist, right? Looks pretty cool. And Gombert, a bounty hunter. I've never seen a bounty hunter before. Melee ranged. Looks like the preferred position is second and third. Last and third. And obviously first and second. So we'll take all of these on board with us because we have the room for them.
The thrill of the hunt. The promise of payment.
Okay, well done.
Shoot, bandage, and pillage. The dancing steps of war.
And this guy's not talking because he's shy, because we Reynolds here. So if we have a look at his neck, he's got the fear of beasts. He's God-fearing. It's gone severe. In town, he will only pray for stress relief. So that's all he will do, is he will only pray. So if we pop him in here and we pray to a higher power, it's going to cost us 1200 buckaroos. Confirm. Get in there. I kneel before you. So he's locked in there for a week and it should reduce his stress. So we'll use this guy instead. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you enjoy it. Let me know what you think down in the comments. Again, if you want to be part of this bunch of misfits, let me know. Let me know what class you'd like to be. Just basically that's it. What class, what name you'd like to have. And until next time, as always, take great care of yourself, be good, be safe, and I will see you in the next one.